A symbol for life, knowledge, and immortality, the Tree of Life is said to represent many things, but they're all wrong because this isn't a tree, and I'm going to prove it to you in 3 minutes or less.
Let's get to it.
The Tree of Life, aka the Tree of Knowledge, the Sacred Tree, the World Tree, and the Cosmic Tree, is an iconic symbol within many of the world's mythologies, religions, and traditions, and, depending on the belief system of each culture and/or how it was interpreted by the scholars, depictions and interpretations vary. So, in order to uncover this symbol's true meaning, we need to locate the source, which, coincidentally enough, resides within the cradle of civilization, ancient Mesopotamia, the Sumerians, and their gods, the Anunnaki. Now, let's just highlight the obvious. This clearly isn't a tree, and to suggest that it is fucking ridiculous. Because A, the Sumerians clearly knew what a tree looked like, and B, symbolism doesn't really apply here because this is literally the first known location where writing appears, so complex word associations with underlying interpretations haven't really made an appearance just yet. And even if they did, A, you would think that some part of this so-called tree would actually look like a tree, and B, they would have referred to it as such. But they didn't. In fact, as is the case with every symbol we see in this depiction, they didn't refer to it as anything. So the word tree comes from us. So let's remove that word and replace it with another one. Something a little bit more age appropriate with a similar style. Maybe something like the Zed, an Egyptian symbol that dates all the way back to 3500 BC and an ancient god named Ptah, who was known as the creator god and maker of things, a patron of craftsmen, and often depicted as the spine of Osiris, who was the god of gods and ruler of Egypt. Now, let's look at these artifacts side by side. Basically mirrored images of one another, and since these civilizations occupy the same region and time period, it would be a logical theory to assume that they're depicting the same thing, making this the Zed and this the Ankh, which is associated with the wife of Osiris, Isis, and symbolizes life, often referred to as the key of life, and is often depicted side by side with the Zed, which, let's just be honest here, looks nothing like a tree. Rather, it looks like this, which, I know, to some may seem like an utterly ridiculous theory, but hear me out on this one. Let's focus on those two key words, life and creation. Or another way we could put that is the creation of life, which could mean that this symbol is really something like the incubator of life. Or it could be something a little bit more grounded, literally. Like maybe this symbol creates life for this symbol. Or another way we could put that, this technology creates energy for this device. Now, I am fully aware that to most people this is wild speculation. However, you're looking at this through a modern day perspective where words like symbolism, myth, and legend have meaning, but those words didn't exist 4,000 years ago or even 1,000 years ago, because they are all modern day words that we made up to explain ancient shit we couldn't explain logically. And since both the Egyptians and the Sumerians clearly knew what a tree was and clearly knew how to depict one accurately, you can safely assume that clearly this is not a tree. How's it going, everybody? Corey James here. Just wanted to say thank you for checking out the video. I very much hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, do the little guy a favor. Hit the buttons, the like, the subscribe. If you're feeling a little frisky, hit that notification bell. Leave me some comments, suggestions on future videos. Do it all. Once again, thank you, and I'll see you on the next one.